Right, so the players that started off in this program in May this year would have gone through a screening process which took place in the zones, girls and boys, Trinidad and Tobago. They would have completed a first block of training up until September, at which point majority of the players would have joined their schools in the SSFL competitions. So that was a time for us to give the players an opportunity to take part in competitive games, give the technical department a chance to review the first block and plan for our second block. So as we know, the SSFL is a key stakeholder for TTFA. So in that way, the league support us with the development of the players. It's an opportunity as well for our coaches who are in the program that would have gotten a chance to go out and watch some of these league games, under 14 especially as one of the main categories, and see the players in that environment, be able to make some general assessments on them, and yes, give them a chance to further their development playing with their school leagues. Yeah, well, one of the main objectives of the high performance program is to be that development process of preparing these players to go into under 17 national teams. So we do look at the holistic development of the players, the technical part, the tactical part, the mental part, and as you mentioned, that we are now in our block two, introducing our strength and conditioning component to the program. Well, in terms of talent ID for the high performance program, it's a continuous process. As we say, it's like a revolving door. The coaches involved in the program are out there constantly looking for players, whether it be in their community leagues, in the schools leagues, whatever location we can get to see the players, we are out there looking. We have as well trusted networks where we know the coaches at the different schools or clubs that would recommend that a player be looked at in the program. We do have a process to accommodate that. So we are constantly looking for the top players in that age group to bring into the program and maintain a training group of about 40 players on a continuous basis. So anybody out there that believes that they are at the level to want to become part of the program, there is definitely an opportunity for them to be seen, to be looked at, and to be assessed with regards to them either joining the program or being looked at and then continuing their development at their clubs. And we can keep in contact with them to monitor their development as well. So in terms of, again, being identified to become part of these programs, there would be windows where we would have further screenings. Again, these will take place in the zones. I would have mentioned earlier that the upcoming leagues, SSFL being included, the coaches are going out and viewing these leagues. So we are constantly looking for players within the age bracket that we can bring into the program and have them train, be assessed, and at that point we determine whether they stay with the program or go back to their clubs for continued development. Yes, again, that's another part of the development as well as talent ID process, the National Youth Leagues that will come 2023, great opportunity again for our coaches to get out there, see the players, play for their clubs in a competitive environment. Again, maybe see players we may not have seen before. A further part of it would be continuing to try to build relationships with the clubs that these players attend. And again, through these trusted networks, we expect to be continuously looking at new talent and existing talent in their environment. Right, so in terms of the staff, all the staff would have come through the coach education department, TTFA. Part of the requirement is that they would all hold a minimum of a B license. So we know that the coaches come with a minimum level of knowledge and experience. For example, we have Coach Denzel Theobald, former national team player, also played at the World Cup in 2006, comes with a vast amount of experience and knowledge of what it takes to play at that level, to represent your country with the coaching knowledge as well. So that we look at as an asset. You have as well coaches that have been to past Youth World Cups, again like Coach Bato would be one of these coaches who again knows what it takes for us to get back to that level. And part of this program again is preparing those players to go into that U17 national level, girls and boys, and get us back to a World Cup, which is one of the big or main objectives of this program, is to support the national team's youth level back up to senior, being able to achieve at the highest level.